evidence to demonstrate the authority of the Messiah, to demonstrate the authority of Jesus. What Christ Jesus can do, the moment a sinner meets him, tonight can be the beginning of your transformation. As you open your heart to receive the light of God, the light of eternity, the light of peace, the pathway of tranquility that is in Jesus. So on this basis, precious people of Great Manchester, we begin with prayers and commit this auspicious moment into the mightiest hands of our great God. Please, shall we pray? Almighty God, we thank you. Eternal God, we bless your holy name. You are the living God. You are the creator of mankind. You are the author of life. You are the hope of humanity. You are the only Savior. Our great God, tonight, we come before you. We come with faith. We come humbling ourselves before you, Lord. We ask you, Daddy, in the name of your son Jesus, touch the hearts of your people. Open their hearts. Give them knowledge. Give them faith to believe. And as they repent and believe in Christ Jesus the Messiah, Father, we pray, forgive their sins, make them born again. This we believe and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So, precious people, we are talking about the kingdom of God. Jesus Christ, the authority of the universe. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life. Jesus Christ, the Savior of mankind. Jesus Christ, the conquering master. Jesus Christ, the one that descended in the grave. He conquered the grave on the one, on the two, on the third day. The Bible said he came back to life. Why did he die? He died because of you and me. Why did he die? He died because of sin. The Lord does not want any of you to go to hell. He died to make a way of escape, so you can repent for your sins and receive the gifts of righteousness and make peace with God that created you. Because the Bible says, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible says, the wages of sin is dead. The penalty of sin is dead. The consequence of sin is dead. The price of sin is dead. The reward of sin is dead. But there is a good news. There is a good news. The Bible also says, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. He did not say to religion. He says, but the gift of God, the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. most interesting question is this. Do you know Jesus? Are you born again? How do you know Jesus? Do you just have a mental knowledge of Jesus? Or do you have an spiritual knowledge of Jesus? Meaning, has Christ the Messiah transformed your life from a sinner to a saint? Has Jesus destroyed the grip, the power of sin in your life? Or are you still a slave to sin? Are you still a prolific liar? Are you still a thief? Shoplifter? Are you still living in sexual immorality? Do you still commit adultery? Do you commit fornication? Do you live with a woman, a man that is not your wife, or your husband? In the name of love, the Bible says, when you sleep with a woman that you are not legitimately, legally married to, you are committing fornication. The Bible says, such people shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Are you like that? When you are sleeping with a woman that you are not married to, you are a thief. You are a thief. You are stealing. You are enjoying marriage before marriage. The Bible says no thief shall inherit the kingdom of God. So if you are living with a woman that is not your wife, if you are living with a man that is not your husband, please today, don't delay, repent, amend your ways before it is too late for you. You do not own your life. You don't know where you are going to die. My dear friends, do you know you have appointment with death? Do you know the Bible says in the book of Hebrews 9, verse number 27, it is appointed unto man once to die, after this judgment. Precious people, you need to understand this. You have appointment with Mr. Dead. Whether you believe it or not, one day, Mr. Dead will knock on your door and say, hello, time up. I want to take you. When Mr. Dead knocks on your door, will you tell Mr. Dead, excuse me, Mr. Dead, I am not yet ready to die. I am just 30 years old. I have many years ahead of me. I still want to enjoy life. Precious people, Mr. Dead is not a diplomat. Mr. Dead is not an ambassador. Mr. Dead is very rude. When Mr. Dead knocks on your door, he will not care whether you are 1 year old. Mr. Dead will not care whether you are 10 years old. Mr. Dead does not care how old you are. When Mr. Dead knocks on your door, when the day of your appointment with Mr. Dead comes, Mr. Dead will snatch you. Mr. Dead will take you. You will cry, Mr. Dead, please don't take me. I am not yet married. Mr. Dead will say, why didn't you believe in Jesus? Only Jesus Christ disgraced me. Mr. Dead will say, listen, you do not believe in Jesus because only Jesus Christ can stop me. If you have religion and you don't have Christ, Mr. Dead will tell you, I have power over you. I have authority. when Mr. Death knocks and he sees the Messiah and he sees Jesus, Mr. Death will run. Mr. Death will cry, because the Bible says when Jesus Christ died, something happened. On the 1, 2, on the very third day, Jesus Christ resurrected. He came back to life. Meaning, dead cannot stop Jesus.
God bless you.
The implication is this. When you are born again, when you have repented from your sins,
hallelujah,
when you believe in the name,
amen,
of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, Mr. Dead has no power. Mr. Dead has no dominion. Mr. Dead has no authority over a born-again child of God. But if you have religion, but if you have philosophy, but if you have only science, when Mr. Dead comes, he will snatch you. When Mr. Dead comes, he will take you. You will cry, Mr. Dead will slap you. My dear friends, the question is this. Do you know Jesus? Do you want to live forever? If you want to live forever, the only way out is this. Run away from your sins. Stop committing sin.
Hallelujah.
Stop committing adultery. Stop sleeping around. Stop jumping from one man to another. Stop jumping from one woman to another. Stop witchcraft. Stop pornography. Stop masturbation. If you continue to commit masturbation, touching your body for pleasure, when you die, Mr. Dad will snatch you into hell. If you continue to live with a woman that is not your wife, in the name of boyfriend, girlfriend, honey, I love you. Listen, if you love her, go and marry her. But if you continue to live with a woman you are not married to, listen to me, you are a thief. You are stealing. Because that woman is not your wife. If you keep stealing her, taking her honor, tomorrow you will leave her. Another man will come and take her. Let me tell you something. That is evil. That is wickedness. And let me tell you, if you continue like that and die, you cannot see heaven. And you know something? If you miss heaven, you can miss hell. What about those men? They are married, and yet they are committing adultery. They will tell their wife, honey, oh, you are so beautiful. I love you so much. You are the best thing that happened to me. The next day, they will see another woman, and they will take her, and they will commit adultery with her. They will return home, and they will look their wife on the face and say, sweetheart, you are gorgeous. And they know they are lying. Are you like that? If you are committing adultery, please repent and amend your ways. Jesus Christ is calling you. Stop committing sin. Sin will send you to hell. Let no man deceive you. Let no one deceive you. No sinner shall enter heaven. That is why Jesus Christ died. He died that we may repent and be saved.